Welcome back to 25 Days of Chrimuh with Cece. So you guys caught me just practicing a little bit. You guys, doesn't that hymn sound familiar? We did it in the last episode, O Come All You Faithful, also known as A Distant Fidelis. Now, if you guys watched the last episode, you saw that I gave you a little bit of history on where the piece came from and little things like that. But now, if you let me, I want to talk a little bit about the technical things of the piece, if you will. For instance, the time signature of O Come All Ye Faithful is 4-4. So first things first, we'll define what the time signature is. Now, this is a neat little rhyme that I learned as a little girl that really helped me remember what the time signature is, and I know it'll do the same for you. So, a time signature has two numbers, the top note and the bottom note, okay? So, this is the rhyme. The top note tells us how many beats are in each measure. Got it? Let's try it one more time together. The top note tells us how many beats are in each measure. So, going on to the next one, the bottom note. The rhyme for the bottom note is, the bottom note tells us what note receives one beat. Cha-cha-cha. Isn't that catchy? I know it was. Shout out to Westminster Elementary School. But the bottom note tells us what note receives one beat, cha-cha-cha. So the time signature of the hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful, is 4-4. So if you can remember that rhyme I just did, that'll tell you that the top note tells us that there are four beats in each measure. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the bottom note tells us what note receives one beat. And in this case, since it is a 4-4 time signature, the quarter note will receive one beat. Now, moving along, if some of you are familiar with the hymnal, you will notice that there is a pickup note before the piece begins. The proper term for a pickup note will be called an anacrusis. Can you say that with me? Anacrusis. An anacrusis is defined as the note that precedes the first downbeat of a musical phrase. So now I'm going to give you guys an example of an anacrusis. So let's review real quick. If there are four beats in each measure and the downbeat comes on beat one, that means that our anacrusis will be beat four. Let me say that one more time for you. If there are four beats in each measure and the downbeat is on beat one, that means our anacrusis will be beat four. So let me direct that for you. Do, do. Now let's count it. 1, 2, 3. 4 down. So, if that makes sense for you guys, let's see if you can conduct it. 1, 2. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Excellent! So now, when you go back to school, or if you're in your elective class for music, you'll know what an anacrusis is, and you'll know what a time signature is. But do not forget that, because we may just revisit it again. So kids, if you didn't know what an anacrusis was or a time signature was, I can guarantee it, you know it now. Until next time, be kind to yourself and be kind to others. See you. Doo-doo.